In this tutorial, you're going to learn how to upload your video to Microsoft Stream in the Office 365 suite. Microsoft Stream is a great place to host videos that you create for the purpose of getting them out to your students and staff so they can watch content that you've pre-created. All right, so there's a couple of ways to do this. One is to send it directly from PowerPoint itself. So I'm in PowerPoint. I recorded my screencast, my screen recording. And so all I have to do now is go up here to File. And then I'm going to come all the way down. I'm not going to save or save as. I'm going to come all the way down to Export. And when I click Export, you'll see here's my option to publish to Microsoft Stream. So I click there. I can give it a title. So this is the EdTech website overview tutorial. I can also give it a description. And then here there's a checkbox on who will have access to this in terms of permissions. Allow everyone in your organization to see this video? Sure. If you want to be specific about who has access, then you'll have to leave that unchecked. And then once it's uploaded to Stream, you'll have to go into Stream and you can either leave it to only you or you can add specific people and give them access to the video. But it's going to save you a lot of headaches to just simply allow access for everyone in your organization. All right, so you also have an option to upload your original PowerPoint. So if you did have slides that went along with this video, you could have that uploaded as well. In this case, I don't have any other slides. So I'm just going to go right to publish. So I'm going to click publish here. And you'll see down here at the very bottom, it's creating the video EdTech website overview. And we have a progress bar. And so it's going to go through that process. Now it's uploading EdTech website overview to Microsoft Stream. And I get a progress bar there. And so we're going to wait and see how that, we're going to come back to this later. But what we're going to do now is I'm going to actually go to Microsoft Stream, which is part of Office 365. So to go to Stream, I'll actually take you from the beginning. You're just going to go to office.com, office.com. Then Stream's going to load here. And you can, well, not Stream. This is Office 365. Then you're going to click the Stream app right here. If you don't see the Stream app there, you can click in the waffle and go to All Apps. And here you'll see the whole list of apps, and you might just have to scroll down a while until you find Stream. Okay, and so when Stream loads, you can simply go here to Create and Upload Video. And so once you get to upload video, you can either drag and drop your video file, or I can click browse. I can go to my videos folder and I can select EdTech overview and upload it this way. So I'll go ahead and show you this. I'm going to rename this one and just call it a test. I'm going to click open. Oh, I'm going to rename it here. So rename it, test, all right, and open. So that's going to upload, and then it gives me the option to actually change the title. It takes the title from your file name, but you could actually change that. You can type in a description. It's going to provide a thumbnail for your video. But you'll also have options of different thumbnails to select here. And now here's where I was talking about permissions. So we said everyone in our organization can view the video. But if I didn't check that box, I could always go back in here and I could actually add specific people. I can click the drop down here, go to people, and I could actually search for people in my organization to give them access to this video. I can always turn this back off where we have allow everyone in your organization to view. So you have a lot of options there in terms of who has access. And then if you go down here to options, this is really cool. So this has people. This will identify people in your video and allow you to jump to those segments of the video where those people show up. But in this case, I actually don't have actual people in the video. It's a screencast. So I'm going to turn that off. I don't need that. Comments is an option if you want people to be able to type comments under the video and ask you questions about it. I like to turn that on in case people have questions. And then this is really cool. Auto-generate a caption file. So Stream will actually analyze all of the spoken word from your video and translate it into a caption file that is read on the right-hand side of the video. Okay, so when you're done setting your options, you click Publish here. Now the video will be published and available on Microsoft Stream. But how do I get that to my specific people that I want to notify about it? Well, I'm going to click Share right here. And then here's the share link. So I can just click copy. Now I've got that copied to my clipboard, and I can paste this link in an email. I can paste it in Microsoft Teams where I collaborate with my colleagues or my students, and they'll have direct access to the video. All right, so that's how you upload your video to Microsoft Stream. Oh, and one last thing before I go. The other video we uploaded straight from PowerPoint. So let's go back to PowerPoint. And it says, successful upload. Your video was successfully uploaded to Microsoft Stream. Click here to view your video. So they give you a direct link right here that will take you to Microsoft Stream and to your video. So we'll let this load so you can see what this looks like. And it'll, here's the video right here. And this is how it looks when people access it. When people access your video to play it back, it looks just like this. You're gonna have the video, you've got playback controls. Then if you scroll down, you've got the comments area where people can type and respond. There's a like button and there's a share button as well. And then if you ever need to go back in and edit this, you can click on your drop-down menu here, and you can go to update video details. You also can trim the video once it's already up here. You can replace it if you end up re-recording what you were trying to share, and you could replace it later. And then you can delete it, and then you can also download it. All right, and so that is Microsoft Stream and how to get your video up there.